unlike normal product development, we didn't go extremely deep on design and write long product requirement documents. The whole spec was 3 pages, and we just threw some people at it and we built a prototype. And as soon as we did that, we realized we were onto something.
Welcome to the Made by Google podcast, where we meet the people who work on the Google products you love. Here's your host, Rashid Finch.
Today, we're talking to Aaron Lynch and Alistair Pott, who work closely with the teams that made Circle to Search.
This is the Made by Google podcast.
Aaron, you've been at Google 14 years. You've worked on products like the Google Assistant, Google Pay, Keep, and now Circle to Search. How is working on Circle to Search different from what came before?
Yeah, Rashid, it's pretty impressive what we were able to do, bringing Google's most well-known product, biggest used product, to an operating system that we own, Android, and making it really easy and accessible for people to fulfill their curiosity. Our mission is to bring the world's information to people and make it easier to access. And that's exactly what we've done. So it's been amazing.
Alistair, you were at Google for 6 years, and then you left, and then you came back. Why is that?
Yeah, great question. I love Google. I had a great time at Google. I worked mostly on Google Play, but I did a number of other things as well. But I'm generally an impatient person. I like to try new things. And so I felt that I needed to go and see how things get done at other big companies. And so I spent 4 years, I sometimes joke, in the wilderness, but actually at great companies, learning a lot from other companies. And ultimately, I just decided that Google is my home. And so I decided to come back. I always seek like opportunities where there's an impactful role or a product that is very, very impactful. And as Aaron was talking about, search is just enormously impactful, 25 years of making people's lives better. And so I joined the search team, and it's been a great year and a half since coming back.
Amazing. So on to new things then, Circle to Search. Let's just get everyone on the same page first. What is Circle to Search and how would I use it?
Great question. So it's on Android only and on Pixel and Samsung phones right now. And what you can do is at the bottom of the screen, long press on the home handle or the home button, depending on which setting you have. And that's it. What happens is we pop up this AI overlay and allow you to circle what you're curious about. And within milliseconds, we return results to fulfill that curiosity.
So I can circle like what, text, images?
Yep, anything. And you can even combine the two. So one beloved feature is the ability to circle something visual and then tap the search box and keep adding questions to refine your query. People are getting a lot of value out of that.
We've had visual searching for a while on Android through Google Lens. How would you say Circle to Search is different from Lens?
So Circle to Search actually works with Lens. A lot of the technology is in fact Lens, the visual searching capabilities, OCR on the screen. The key differences are really that it's universally available. So Aaron described this. But you can invoke Circle to Search over any app. You can be doing anything on your phone and call on Google to satisfy curiosity about what you're seeing. And that is a huge difference. We also made some differences to the UI. We added a little shimmer that we really love. And of course, we introduced the circle gesture itself. So now, instead of only tapping on things, you can also circle things to let Google know what you're curious about.
Yeah, I love the shimmer and the sort of feeling that your phone makes when you keep the button pressed right on the bottom. That's really great. I'm curious about the origin story of Circle to Search, if there is one. I imagine maybe someone one day stormed into a room and said, hey, I've got this great idea. How did this start? Like, who came up with this? And how do you build it into an actual product?
Yeah, there was no, as far as I know, eureka moment with someone storming into a room and shouting, I've got it. Instead, I think that most folks knew that Lens is really, really powerful, but also it's a bit of a pain sometimes to have to take a screenshot and share it with Lens. So we'd often dreamed about what could it take to bring Lens to anywhere on the phone. And so we'd been thinking about this and noodling on it and the idea of making it easy for natural and intuitive for people to satisfy their curiosity. And then in January or so of last year, we actually decided, let's kick this off. Let's see how we could do it. And the way that we decided to do that was by building a prototype. So unlike normal product development, we didn't go extremely deep on design and write long product requirement documents. The whole spec was 3 pages, and we just threw some people at it and we built a prototype. And as soon as we did that, we realized we were onto something. It just felt so good immediately that we then began to invest quite heavily in the product.
So it was this really exciting opportunity where Android woke up and thought, wow, what could we bring In fact, there was a big debate too about the circle gesture itself, because tapping is the way Lens has always worked, and tapping is actually faster. But we very quickly learned, as Alistair pointed out, once we had the prototype in our hand, wow, it is delightful to circle. It just feels more intuitive. It feels like you're more participant in the use case and in the scenario. And so it was really fun.
I guess often it's not easy to sort of make something that's equally powerful and easy to use. That was probably the goal of Circle to Search in a way.
Without a doubt. We constantly have been talking about natural and intuitive. Those are words that we speak a lot about, helping users to satisfy their information needs. We also have been extremely focused on speed. A lot of the magic of Circle to Search is how quick it is to use, and then also how quick it is to get back to what you were doing. We don't want to be in your way. We want to get in, help you, and then get out of your way so that you can carry on with what you were doing.
Are there any favorite examples already that you've seen people use Circle to Search? Maybe yourself, you have any experience of something that was maybe harder to do in the past that is now really easy and fun to do on your phone?
I was going to call out using Circle to Search on text. Like, it's a very visual product, but in fact, it works extremely well when selecting text. You can just draw a line through the text or scribble over text to select it. And I use it very, very often on that. I found over time that I use it more and more for text. And we've seen this in the data with real people as well. They are slowly learning, oh, wow, this is a really quick way to search text. And along with text, a use case that I, especially when traveling, have been leaning on is Translate. So as soon as you select text, you can immediately translate it. And we just launched a full screen translate. So there's now a little button that'll actually translate the whole screen in place, which is pretty magical.
Right now, it's just filling my toxic trait, which is celebrity news and looking
right.
at pictures of celebrities out in the world. It's terrible. But now, whenever I'm doing that, you know, killing time, I can trigger Circle to Search and just check out, ooh, what's that bag? Who made the bag? How much is it? Are there any knockoffs? Ooh, what is that shoe? That's kind of a new style I haven't seen before. So that's my favorite use case right now. I'm shameful to admit.
I wanted to pick up on something you mentioned. So it's called Circle to Search, but it could have maybe also been Scribble to Search or Draw a Line to Search. So two questions there. First of all, when it comes to circling, like, do I need to be really good and precise with my circling? Or is that not really necessary? So like, how do you fully understand what I've been intending to search? And maybe the same question also for the scribbling and the lines. How do you make that work and understand what I'm trying to get?
Very interesting question. And the answer in brief is no, you don't have to be very precise at all. We have found that users are quite precise, even when they're doing it very, very quickly. But as soon as you invoke Circle to Search on device only, we are analyzing what is on the screen and segmenting it. So we do a lot of optical character recognition to figure out where the strings are that are selectable. And then Lens has got just phenomenal on-device models that can also detect the objects on the screen. And so when you're doing a circle, we've very, very finely tuned the region selection over lots and lots of testing so that it's extremely accurate. We have a prototype with a very, very thick line that can sometimes feel imprecise because you really like can't do very, very fine drawing. And it just works perfectly. It works really, really well because of all this technology that we've built into the product.
Yeah, and to add to that too, my favorite thing to do is Circle to Search is great when you need to grab a lot of text to ask a question about it. I've learned over time to grab from the first word to the last word, and we're smart enough to select it all. And oftentimes, an AI answer comes up. I don't want to understate how interesting that is. Our users, as we're learning from them, are wowed by search generative experiences. And my favorite thing is to grab a bunch of text and have AI answer or explain something to me. For example, sometimes I'm reading an article and there's something inferred in the words that I don't get. And so if I highlight it, often AI will help fill me in on what they're trying to get across in the sentence.
I totally agree. It often feels very magical to do that.
I'm wondering what it feels like to work on the product that started it all like over 25 years ago. I mean, we all know the text box and we added voice search, search through Google Lens. Now you get the chance to add another way of accessing the search engine. What does it feel like to work on that?
It's been really, really fun. So the first is, like, we both believe and the team believes this actually is making search more natural and intuitive for people. So we all became product managers to build products that people love. And so that's been great. Erin alluded to this, but this has also been a project that's required a lot of cross-Google collaboration. You know, we worked super closely with the Lens team, with all sorts of search teams, and then the Android team as well. And it's been really, really fun to see the company just come together and work across organizational lines. I've loved that. And then lastly, the product is cool. Like I'm proud of the fact that it is cool. This is the first time in my career that my mom is actually like aware of what I've done and happy and proud of what I've done. And that's something that I've really, really enjoyed.
From where I sit, the coolest part of this is we're bringing Lens and Search together more. So a visual question that somebody asks, there's usually a grid of similar images that appear, but I'm really excited about our actually merging of both the search result page with the Lens result page, and that's going to be rolling out over many, many months.
So we talked about how this is a big change for search. On the other end, I guess it's also a big change for Android in a way, because you need to talk to the Android folks and tell them like, hey, you know, that button that you press to get home or that you swipe up to get home, we want to extend the functionality of that. I'm wondering what that conversation was like, because they're probably protective of that functionality.
Yeah, this was one of the more complicated things that we were mired in. And Alistair, can you remember the early days of the prototype? It was so hard to get the search folks to set up their Android device because it took a special Android build that you had to flash, and it was very, very complicated and painful. We spent a ton of time thinking about what is the fastest way to access, because we knew that could make or break the product. I'm really excited where we landed. We still have further to go, and we're working a lot on making sure it's triggered when you want, it's not triggered when you don't want. But the main point was to make this be a system affordance, as we talk about internally. Anywhere you are, regardless of the app, regardless of the state, you can trigger this. That was a key for us.
I think we're also excited about the future. We think that this universal access to the power of Google is really, really interesting. And we have lots of ideas about what to do.
Okay, then. So let's say someone has a Pixel device. They have not tried Circle to Search yet. What is the first thing maybe they should try with Circle to Search? What do you think will give them the best impression of what the feature is capable of?
I would say whatever app that they spend the most time in, whether it's social media or text messaging or what have you, if you have a Pixel 6 and above, and a Pixel Fold is now supported as well, just try it out. Trigger over anything and begin your circling experience, and try even copying text. It's so silly to say. I was so questioning whether we should include copy text in the product, but now I use it all the time, right? The ability to just really quickly grab something over any app.
Alistair?
I think that's absolutely right. Earlier on, I was talking about how like I find text extremely useful, but the visual search is truly magical. And so I would like get onto a social app, or it works on video as well. So a like short form video app. And the first time you see a beautiful building or a natural spot and you don't know exactly where it is, just call on Circle to Search. And that first use really does feel magical. And so I'd recommend that.
The other thing that I'm really excited about too, and people do a lot, is use your camera and then trigger Circle to Search. So I have a friend of mine who had this awesome water bottle that I was obsessed with, and I just took out my Pixel, double tapped on the power button to bring up the camera, just pointed it at it, triggered Circle to Search, and bam, I saw where I could buy that water bottle, what it was called, the price, etc. So I highly recommend that too.
That's probably one that maybe you didn't think of when building the feature. It's only when you have it in your hands, you're like, hey, maybe I can actually sort of use the viewfinder in this way.
Exactly.
It's been fantastic to see users figure it out and try new things. So the viewfinder was one. We've also seen people ask search generative experiences like surprising questions about the things that they are circling. And oftentimes it just works. I play a word game called Connections, where you have to group words into groups of four. And I was like wondering, hey, I wonder how SGE works on that. And it did okay.
It sounds to me like, you know, both of you feel this is one of the perhaps more rewarding things you've been working on at Google.
For sure. Two highlights to me over the last year of working on this project. The first was amazing my kids when I got invited to visit Mr. Beast to shoot a video related to Circle to Search that we got him to circle a Feastables video. Alistair mentioned it's really useful to grab things over a video and look something up. And so that was really cool to spend 3 days at his compound in North Carolina. The other highlight for me is friends of mine who don't have an Android phone being really disappointed that they can't get this. Friends of mine who don't have Android say, ooh, wow, I wish I had this. That is the coolest thing. And so I'm really, really proud of what we've done.
Yeah, I had that experience last night. I was hanging out with some friends and we used Circle to Search. And she's like, oh, cool, show me how to do that. I was like, sorry, you can't. You're on an iPhone. So that was great. I talked about a number of the things I liked. I'll talk about two that are kind of in contrast. So one was the speed that this all came about with. Like, I like to move really, really fast. And as I mentioned, we had a prototype really quickly that was fantastic. And then we moved extremely fast to bring it to market. We also spent a lot of time on quality and on polish, making it a truly fantastic product before we shipped it. And I'm very proud of that.
On the speed aspect, one of the most impressed I was as well was the team that we had. We were available in lots of time zones. So throughout the prototyping and as we were building towards launch, we had folks waking up in London to then hand off to folks on the East Coast, to hand off to folks on the West Coast, to be up super late if we needed to be. It was an amazing around the clock. The other thing, I think Alistair hinted at this as well, we could have added so much complexity, but we kept it simple, right? So often it's very natural to think, oh, let me add one more thing or one more thing. And if we had done that, it could have distracted us. It also could have taken away from how simple and wonderful this is to just be nosy in a moment and pull up Circle to Search and circle that thing. So really awesome by the team to keep both of those things going.
Erin, Alistair, thank you so much for joining the Made by Google podcast and, of course, also for bringing us Circle to Search. I guess all of us will be circling a lot in the near future. Thank you again.
Thanks
for having us.
Thank you for listening to the Made by Google podcast. Don't miss out on new episodes. Subscribe now wherever you get your podcasts to be the first to listen.